and chips.
Hey, let's move on to something you've all been waiting for. Michael and I certainly have. Australian rock legends The Church are celebrating four decades of creating and performing some of the country's best love songs, and they're still releasing new music. This month, the band's returning to the stage in Melbourne to play hits, including this one.
And Steve Kilbey from The Church joins us now. Steve, g'day. Great to see you again and congratulations on this anniversary.
Thank you very much.
40 years is no mean feat. Does it make you feel old?
No. I started the band when I was minus 15.
Of course you did. You don't look a day over 30, 40.
Oh, if I had a dollar for every time I'd sung that song or Unguarded Moment. At the time, do you remember thinking among the band, you know, this could be it, this could be our life, we've nailed this?
I said to the guys, in 40 years' time, I'll be on the ABC still talking about these songs. And they sneered.
Was it true one of your original ambitions back in the day was to, A, crack a hit single, which would enable you to play a gig in Melbourne?
A single to show to my grandchildren. I wanted one single and I wanted to do one gig in Melbourne. And if I could have fulfilled those ambitions, I would have died a happy man and exited the music business.
Yeah, wow.
You've exceeded the KPIs on that front, Steve.
And now look, I'm in this lovely place here by the harbour.
By the harbour.
No, beautiful. What a bummer that you couldn't play at Byron Bay at the Blues Fest.
Oh, why'd you bring it up again?
Oh, because you're about to play next week and all is good in the world.
Well, yeah, that was the Byron Bay's Blues Fest, and we had a secret gig, and we haven't played with our new guitarist, Ash Naylor, yet.
Yeah, because he only joined a couple of years ago, didn't he?
He joined a couple of years. We haven't got a chance to bloody play yet. So he's got a baptism of fire at this gig in Melbourne, like in front of a load of people in a big outdoor gig he's got to walk on and...
April.
He's a trooper.
He's a trooper, a great guitarist. So you're playing at the April Sun Festival in Melbourne next Wednesday. Lots of people, as you say, looking forward to that, Steve. Now, 40 years down the track, you're the only effectively surviving band member.
I'm the only survivor of the whole thing, yeah?
Does that mean you've managed to annoy all the other guitar players and drummers and the like that have come
and gone? Well, the drummer's been around for a while.
the drummer's been around for a while. I'm just such, you know, it's... You know, what can you say, you know? Some of them did a long time, like a long stretch. Can you imagine 39 years of maximum rock and roll? And then, you know, guys just burn out and they've had enough of me and, you know, that's it.
It's a tough
business. But we did pretty well.
Oh, you've done more than pretty well and you're making new music, putting down some more tracks, we hear.
Still making new music. I've made like 5 albums in the last year. So, and I painted a picture for this year's Archibald Prize, which I think will probably win.
Okay. Early and big call. Who's the picture of?
It's me, because I'm the only famous person I know who would... I'm not even famous. Person I knew who would sit down for a portrait long enough.
Self-portrait Steve Kilbey. Okay, early favourite for the Archibalds. Well, what's that?
Yeah.
Packing room prize.
Excellent.
Hey, Steve, how are you preparing for these concerts next week, the April Sun concerts? It is going to be big because Melbourne has gone through a bit of a shocker of a year and so many people...
I know. You know what I do?
What?
I put on my old records and I got a tennis racket and I mime in the mirror. I kept getting my moves back. After all, it's not going to come to me, all that sort of Matadorian stuff I was doing.
You know what? I don't think you're joking either.
I'm not.
Hey, how tough was it? I know you did some fantastic, you know, mini concerts from home and entertained your fans online last year, but how challenging was it for you and all the musos you knew during the year of lockdowns last year?
I think everybody had a different story and some people were really devastated. Myself, I got into the Instagram thing and then I rediscovered how much I love playing the 12-string guitar.
Yes.
And it sort of turned into a whole new period of writing songs, because when I write songs all the time except when I'm on the road. So if I'm in America for like 6 months, I don't write any songs. I've had enough. But being at home and only doing those Instagram shows, I started to really write a whole load of new songs. So that it was good for me in that way.
Oh, it's good for the rest of us as well. Yeah. We can't wait. Hey, Steve Kilbey, thanks for joining us this morning and congratulations on everything you've achieved. Hope the concerts next week are awesome.
Thank you very much, guys.
Thank you, Steve Kilbey there in Catch the Church and a range of other great music acts at the April Sun Festival in Melbourne, which I think kicks off this weekend.